AI native networking. Why is it so important and what does it mean for the teams that are working with networking? I'm here with Manoj. We are MWC at the Juniper booth. You're the CEO at Juniper Networks. Maybe you can give a short introduction to kick it off.
Absolutely. My name is Manoj Leelanivas, Chief Operating Officer, Juniper Networks. I'm responsible for products, engineering, cloud operations, marketing, a lot of operational parts of making the AI native networking possible at Juniper.
Yeah, and AI native networking is so important, but can you explain what it is and why is it so important?
If you look at what's happening today, we expect self-driving cars. You know, we actually trust our lives with the self-driving cars. I actually drive a Tesla all the way to work on a self-driving mode. When we have this much expectations of our cars, why don't we have a higher expectation out of our networks? For instance, if a network is not functioning properly, bad things can happen. Imagine you're watching the finals of the 100-meter dash in Olympics, which is going to come pretty shortly, and missing even a 10 seconds outage in networking means you won't miss the you'll completely miss the final second. You don't want that. You have, you know, companies like Amazon shipping lots and lots of packages across the world. An hour of downtime means, you know, $50 million of lost revenue.
That's what you don't want.
Yeah, you definitely don't want that. And if you look at even more serious, talking about life, right? Patients in hospitals, you know, if you have a 10-second outage, that means a particular patient can ELOP, which means that the patient is gone, and that's a life-threatening situation. So if the network doesn't work, you have these life-threatening situations or business-impacting situations, which is why every connection matters. And we believe at Juniper that every one of your connection matters, and that's why we have this AI networking platform to make sure that each connection is solid. And an AI networking platform means it has the right data. We collect all the insights from on a per-user basis, per-session basis, per-app basis into our cloud, and then we use our AI algorithms and munch on it, and then we give you the right insights. What does the insight mean? You actually look at problems before they happen. You find problems before they happen, and we actually solve it. So the network can be self-healing and self-correcting. No more of the 10-second, 30-second, or hour downtimes anymore. Just make it all self-healing and self-correcting. And this is all possible because we have an amazing infrastructure based on a cloud-native, microservices-based architecture which scales from the smallest of customers to the largest of the Fortune 1 or the Global 1 customers. So it's an amazing infrastructure which provides you this self-driving, self-healing network. And that's what the AI-native platform is all about.
That's important because the end user shouldn't even notice it. That's, I think, the key. And if we look a little bit more in history, we had the internet coming and we needed fast routers. Can you compare it now with the AI trend as well? Is it the same or is it different?
Great, great observation. If you look at the internet 20, 25 years ago, internet revolution happened, and there was a trigger for it. That was the smartphone, the advent of the smartphone. In many ways, we think that today's AI revolution is going to be much bigger than that. And there is multiple reasons for this. When we look at AI, we look at AI in two fronts. One is AI for networking. You know, how do you make AI and AI ops in such a way that networking is made easy? You know, gone are the days where operators are sitting on a swivel chair going from dashboard to dashboard to dashboard. You want to make things self-healing, self-working, that part of it. The second part is basically about networking for AI. Mm-hmm. How do we make sure that these amazing learning, training models, you know, trillions and trillions of parameters are actually working flawlessly? And inference models on the edge, they're also scaling. For that, it's not just the GPUs which you need to have this training. You also need to make sure that the network is flawless so that these elephant flows, which have very low entropy, are actually taken care of properly. And you need to have the right network designs, 800 gig routers and switches, which are aptly designed for that. The software, which can take off the complex RDMA processing to make sure that everything is flawless. Because you want to maximize these GPUs. You know, they're very expensive creatures. So you want to maximize the usage. So you want to have the network and the software work on that. And we have a control point called Apstra, which makes sure that all these three things come together. So we work on the networking part to make networking for AI, you know, better. So both combinations of that is actually very powerful, and this is what Juniper is focusing on.
Yeah, and you were talking about the teams, making it easier for the teams. I want to address that part a little bit more. What does it mean for networking teams and for the networking business? Does it implicate their work, make it make things easier?
So our focus has been always about providing the best experiences. How do we simplify the operator experience? How do you make the end user experience flawless? And when you look at simplifying the operator experience, there's one thing which comes to mind. If you look back at the past, the network analysts and the network operators were struggling with reams and reams of data. They were going from one dashboard to another dashboard on the swivel chair to figure out where the problem is. Those days are gone. With our AI native network, we can actually figure out all the telemetry which is needed, have the AI insights, and self-correct the problems in the network. So much so that customers like ServiceNow, which we have been able to reduce 90% of their trouble tickets with the Juniper solution. One of the largest logistic providers in the world, they've been able to reduce 90% of their issues. Mean time to resolution of issues, the time has been reduced. And when you save this time, you give time back to people to do more productive, more creative work. And this also means, from the business point of view, you are now getting to business outcomes. Business outcomes where no more trouble tickets, or 90% of trouble tickets gone, which means that your business is now faster. You don't need to spend a lot of money on people to do the mundane work. You can spend money on people to do the creative work. So it actually brings time back to people, and wonderful things can happen as you deliver those business outcomes. So this is the exciting time.
It's exciting, and I think it addressed this 90% reduction, really addressed what AI native stands for. Manoj, thanks a lot for an exciting time here at MWC, and let's see what AI native is going to bring us the coming years. Thanks a lot.
Great to talk to you, Ronald.
Thank you.